over there, they may resist in the West, but also this type of people, they would usually go for the alternative media and would be all excited about the disclosure and go out of curiosity. And curiosity killed the cat, and the cat was lucky, but the people who go in the cabins for so-called healing, they will want to die as the cat, but they won't be able to. After a temporary healing, of course, they will get even more sick shortly after that. I don't know, will it be like weeks or months or maybe even a couple of years, which I doubt. So sickness they will get anyway much more, but that will be a small part of the entire package. What they will be trading is remotely similar to selling a ton of gold for 2 cents. Even it will be a worse deal than that even. Because these machines in these kiosks that they will be setting up, and for which the people will be lining up like crazy in long lines, taking their children along, what this equipment will do, it will really, when the people go inside the cabin, they will come out a different species. They will already belong to the devil race. Even to the point that after they come out of the cabins, they will be immortal, which will be quite a problem actually, because the suffering which awaits for them after that will be such an agony that many of them all the time will try to commit suicide, but it will be not possible. It will be not possible at all, because this race of demons, they are kind of semi-material as well. This is the word he used, Vyacheslav used. They come from the lowest regions of this huge earthly structure. And for our standards, they're like immortal, like ghosts. That we know from many other also older sources. Vyacheslav gave the example of his own hometown, Chebarkul. It's not a big town, just 40,000 or 50,000 people, something of that sort. He said even here, they will set up one kiosk very near to the place where he used to play with the children in between buildings. And after their campaign, only a couple of people from the entire city will remain human. It will be so successful, this devilish idea with the UFOs. And curiosity will play a big role, very big role. You know, people will say, let's give it a try. You can't just give it a try, actually, it will be too late. Now, Otrok Vyacheslav always used to say that aliens, in the way people think of it nowadays, on the earth, there aren't any, there will be none, and there have been never, because the creation of the Lord is like this, that every race lives in the world created for it. And that is exactly the case in the video about the Sumerians. I give the information from the set material of how actually when out of earthly consciousnesses want to experience earthly life, how do they come here? They come by taking birth in a human body. And in the ancient Vedic books, you can find countless stories explaining exactly this, that when entities from other races want for some reason to come here and do something, they always do it by taking birth here. It's not, this entire thing with the ships is a setup. When they want to come just for a sneak peek, that also Vyacheslav explained, when these devils, which actually live in the lowest regions of this earthly structure, explained in the previous episode, if they want to have a sneak peek of our reality or do something quickly on a short notice without taking a birth, what they do is they grow a human outfit, like human skin. People go to the hospital and they are telling them, we need a bit of a skin to test you. But actually it goes for their devilish laboratories, and they will grow an outfit resembling another human, and then the devil will enter it. and will mingle with the people, and nobody will recognize them. And in the past, when people knew better what is what, they had other words, evil spirits and angels or entities from other realms. But now they decided to mix it all up in the alien categories so that the difference between good and bad is blurred. So it is not technically really incorrect if we think about it to call these devils in the UFO aliens, because they come out of the realm in which we know at least the portion of the earth we call our home. They come from outside of that, so it's not technically wrong. But the problem is that when we use the term alien, then the entire epic adventures thrill created by Hollywood and the entire curiosity and the question, are they good or bad, these things are associated with this very name. That's why Prof. Vyacheslav was very much against this term, and he insisted that they should be called with their proper names, which are which is evil spirits. He also told about another episode to his mother in which she will be involved. By the time this UFO campaign starts, the harvesting campaign with codename UFO starts, he would mean quite he will be way more famous, and people in Russia will listen to what his mother says, because she will be still alive. And when in Moscow the government, they realize how much the entire nation listens to his mother and how much she means for the entire nation, they will not even invite her to Moscow. They themselves, the government, will visit her in her house to show passive respect, and they will bring these fat files with evidence that it is all aliens and your son didn't tell it exactly correct. But he will be famous by then, because everything that he would have told would be happening exactly as he told it. So they will come with all that evidence, and she will see all that.
Do you think you could ask the doctor to phone me back, please?
Doctor, I'm afraid you need to give
something
tomorrow between 8 and 10.
8 and 10. Is there any like cancellation this day or?
No, we haven't got surgery this afternoon. What's the problem?
I just need to talk to him about the dosage of my medication.
Yeah, can it wait till tomorrow?
Yeah, sure. No, it's not urgent.
Right. Yeah, so give us something tomorrow between 8 and 10.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Bye now. Bye. Bye-bye.
Such things in those files, and so many of them, that even you will be confused, and for a moment you will think, well, maybe Utrov Vyacheslav, maybe he made a mistake only for this thing, maybe they are really aliens. Even she will think that for a moment. But eventually she will tell them that, sorry, I don't intend to call them aliens. And then they will take her to Moscow. And that will be the most difficult time in her life. And they will organize this live broadcast on the first and most popular TV channel on Russia, which everybody watches. So it means this will be happening still at the time when they have electricity over there. They will groom her for this broadcast, and they will tell her what to say, and it will start. And then what will happen, that I don't know in what means they will be convincing her to say the things they want, but in the moment the broadcast starts, her mind will be emptied. Even if she wanted to, she would not remember all those things, all the lies they told her. And then she will recover all her memory, and because the broadcast will be live, she will tell to the nation once again what were the real words of Prof. Vyacheslav. And instead of a setup, it will turn into an opportunity, one more opportunity for the nation to hear the truth. And all this evidence, it will be of course all lies or truth mixed with lies as usual, it's becoming, it begins to surface already. this entire branch of the alternative media, which actually consists often of sincere people who are themselves misled, not necessarily very bright, or many of them could be actually devils in human skin, one never knows. So all these creatures, they are already having us main evidence that the UFOs are our well-wishers. The fact, they say, that too many people report good results after meeting them, and they believe that they are spiritual, and they feel happy, and they are okay. And this is the evidence, they say, and it's quite a lot of them, they say. I don't know if they are really such people, but actually probably they are. How do we know they are even people, first of all? How many are there? Nobody can check. And most likely the people who you will hear give testimony in positive way about their experience with the aliens, this will be possessed souls who will sound sincere, because they are sincere, just they will be not aware that they are already dictated by the remote server what to say and what to think, and because they are weak, they take this dictation of their own tone. It's not that all races besides human are evil, it's just the ones that who will have access to us to freely mingle with us during the tribulation. They will be only the bad ones, and angels will be intervening, of course, but they will, because angels, they also take whatever form they want. They will not want to portray themselves as aliens when they get in touch with the people whom they help, because that's already a polluted term. It's already a fiction created by the dark forces, so the angels will not use that type of association when they contact the people whom they are helping. So all the UFOs that you will see during the tribulation, they are all bad, no exceptions. Yes, we heard from Alexander Paramonov that all these races as well will go through the tribulation and get polarized, and that suggests that amongst them as well there will be souls who will go for the truth, but I guess their number won't be much. Like, for example, the Greys, which are in over a bad race, I mean, they mutilate cattle, it's obvious that they are evil, but amongst them they are also good souls, it seems. Well, if there will be so little percentage of sane people remaining on earth amongst the people, although we are way more divine race than them, then what kind of small percentage will be amongst the predominantly evil races, even less? So there is no chance that there will be anything good coming from any UFO. And these fake alternative media who are making you eager for the disclosure already, they have started. They have pre-written, you know, clever tricks to answer all the doubts that, you know, normal people will have. First of all, they will say, of course, but this, you know, they have been mutilating cattle, torturing people between time. They will say, oh, do you say that all aliens are that? Of course they are not, they are good and bad. Well, this is irrelevant, because curiosity will kill you, and you will have no way to check after your soul is taken away. And that's what they are after, for sure. Another thing relearned in English fake media is, if you ask them about the implants torture, ah, yeah, that is true, but you know, nowadays you put implant in your dog to know where it is, and you find it, if it is lost, does it mean that you are evil? So you see, implants are not always evil. And sometimes they have very clever pre-learned answers. When I saw the panel, I said, but you know, they were really good, why wouldn't they all suddenly come and tell what they are doing to people instead of abducting them and implanting them with organ pain and torture? Is this something a gentleman race will do? Obviously not. And you know what is the answer? You know they are doing it undercover because the humanity has not yet
Go on, sign me out.
Actually, it is true that humanity has not evolved to understand much of anything at all. That is the truth. But what? So they are not openly connecting, you know, to people. But they think that our governments have evolved enough to understand them. That's why they're in bed with them. Yeah? This is so preposterous. This is so preposterous and so dangerous. But when you're amongst many people who all agree with that, you will also almost agree with them. This is extremely, extremely dangerous. They will use sophism to confuse the minds of the crowds. They will start talking that, you see, you need to understand, it's not so simple, every race is different, and they will start clogging up your mind with all kinds of useless information or straightforward disinformation about the races. Although ultimately this is absolutely meaningless, because as I said, these are shapeshifters, the bad ones, and this is even known from historic literature very, very well, the bad ones, they pretend to be good ones, depending on what the person they are dealing with believes is a good alien or good angel. That's their regular trick. So the entire, it depends on the race talk, will be nothing else but useless mental garbage from every point of view. And whoever doesn't fall in that trap from the crowd, then those positive alien agenda people, they will pull out the ultimate convincing trick. Oh, you're unspiritual because you're so negative and you don't believe in the positive, and you are making your dark reality with your doubts. And turning to my recent discussion, which I had with somebody about it, and then an elderly Swiss gentleman joined the conversation, and he said, you know, I had implants for so many years, it shows on x-ray, even the doctors agreed, so everything's confirmed, he said, and for so many years I'm fine. What does it mean you are fine? Are you completely healthy? I didn't ask him, but it's extremely rare that they are healthy people nowadays at all. And the other thing is, how would you know in what state would your consciousness be if you didn't have the implant? That is the most important question. And Dr. Vyacheslav said that this will be one of the many ways in which they will trick the different groups of people, depending on what they believe. Other tricks will be, you know, people who are into finance and this type of thing. They will be tricked by the new and fair financial system, which even Dr. Vyacheslav said will be about very fair distribution of goods. It will be made to function in such a way, and it will be so secure. And that's why I see already people calling for the cryptocurrencies, the quantum financial system. They say that this will be the new age. So what Dr. Vyacheslav said about this system is distribution itself will be really very well made. The only problem is that it will function just for a couple of months until they run out of supplies, which they have hidden when the now. At this time they are hiding it when the earth is still giving produce. And once they run out of supplies, the entire system will be pointless. There will be no goods anyway to distribute, and it will be then total hell. But of course, to participate in that system, one would need to get marked, and then it will be again the same deal, selling one's soul for a couple of weeks or months of partial relief of suffering. Very, very partial, because even if they get better food or goods, still the mental turmoil will be severe. And at least of my own experience, desperation cannot even compare to starvation or any other physical suffering. I think the mental pain is way worse. And I'm really talking from experience about the starvation as well, because during the period of more than 1 year in Peru, I often starve very badly, not because of lack of money, just because the entire setup, it was very difficult to procure something that I could eat in this setup in which I lived. So, but it wasn't a major problem for me. I really lost a lot of weight, but I don't even remember it causing any particular major inconvenience. So I asked the person who is convinced that the grace will come to upgrade his genes and make him a Superman. I asked him, how can you believe such a thing? Creatures which mutilate cattle, who are in bed with our rotten governments, and they have tortured so many abductees. You think they'll upgrade to something better when they do such things? And he said, yes, such incidents cannot be denied, but you know, this is nothing out of the ordinary. This is how life has been, you know, and the governments, they needed secrecy. We can see that from history.
It's normal not always to be upfront.
Actually, this answer he gave me is revealing the ultimate truth, which is, by the way, underlined in the Bible, in the Quran, and in the Vedas again and again. Whatever you believe in, that's where you will go to. And people who believe that it is normal, all this torture and secrecy, by the way, quoting only the very recent period of history when lunatics and devils in human skin run the show, that type of history they mention only. They don't mention Satya Yuga, when people lived disease-free and the kings were upfront. But when they consider all that normal, whoever considers all that to be normal and not out of the ordinary, they will go to a place where that is indeed the norm. While those who believe until the end that these things are utterly unacceptable for a normal human, well, those are the meek who will inherit the earth, a very different earth, where people don't need painful implants or surgeries. Just because there isn't anybody to develop all these diseases for them, or feed them genetically modified food, or organize unnecessary pollution to make them sick, and in this way talk them into painful and often harmful medical or so-called medical procedure. Chief director of all UFOs, the Antichrist, the Dajjal, probably I just love describing him as his face is white like flour with red eyes, and he stinks terribly like hell. However, the people cannot feel neither the smell nor they can see his real face. Instead, they see a mental image, and everybody sees a different mental image. Most of them find him very attractive, and also they see him as if the lord of their own religion, or at least his admirers will have that type of visual perceptions. And because he will travel so fast, within seconds, he will reach one city after another. That's why people will be under the impression that he is at a few places simultaneously. Even in the hometown of Rav Vyacheslav, Chebarkul, he will be there a few times, although it's a relatively very minor place. And his performances, he described him like this. First, the people will ask him questions.
Pardon me. Just came up to say hello, now we're going back down below.
Deceptive liars, speakers, he will give very convincing answers. And after that he will show miracles to the people. Now, what type of miracles? For example, they will have a wagon or a big container empty.
and they will place only one container of milk or whatever, some sweets. Then they will close the doors and open again, and it will be full inside of thousands of such packets of milk. And he will give them to the people, to the hungry people, and they will be real. They will eat, and it will be a real milk, and they will believe. Now, what they don't see and what they don't understand is that these evil spirits, they are masters of fast traveling. And in this short moment while they close the container, before they open it again, within 1 second, the evil spirits, they are able to transport all the other yogurt from their storage place. So this is a very simple logistics trick, just because people don't know, don't understand that the devils have this ability to move very fast. They don't have this gift from God to really create something nice like milk. They can only destroy things. They can lie about things, make things look what they are actually not. But they cannot create something nice. And once their old supplies of powder milk or whatever they have made it from, once they run out of that, these tricks, they won't be possible anymore, because there won't be any real food. Only one of the Antichrist's so-called miracles will be real, and that will be fire from the skies. And that will be actually a simple chemical reaction, because the skies are already full with so much flammable pollution, and that will be very easy to achieve with easy chemical and physics setup. So that will be the only real thing he will show. Otherwise, the rest will be but yet people will think that they touch a real thing, because the Antichrist is a fallen angel. He's got magic powers to, you know, make people believe certain things. So he's got powers of this type to create such hallucinations as well. And the nearer we get to the very end, the more the devil and their chief will be showing their real form, in which they wander in hell. For example, Vyacheslav described such an incident, and the devils, they would set up tables right on the streets to
we're in a long way, man. I'm going to have to leave it there. 28 minutes.